Hey, Matt 31, I had a question coming out of section 6.1, number 53. And here we were asked to find an exponential model with these two points in here. So what I did was I went into my lists and I put the data in. I put the x values into L1 and the y values into L2. If we wanted to make a scatter plot off of these right now, I have a fun little residual plot. Let me just show you what this graph would look like. It's not going to look very, oops, sometimes that happens. When that happens, if you're ever trying to make a scatter plot, just hit your home button and then hit zoom 9. I never quite know why that happens on the TI-84s. So since there's only two points, it actually kind of looks like a linear model would work. But this asked us to find, if you look here, it said find an exponential model. So they want some kind of curve going into this. So I can do that. So let me go back to my home screen. We're going to hit stat. We're going to go over to calc. And either you have the options memorized. Oh, sorry, you're hearing my email come in. You might have the options memorized for stat calc exponential regression. It's down at zero. I actually think it's easier to head this way. And there we go, get to exponential regression. And then I just need to do L1, comma L2. And for me personally, I always just get in the habit of storing it into Y1. And then when I run that, you can see there's my exponential function. So I've got my initial value at about 18, and my base is 1.025. So that's what I would be plugging in for my exponential model. And you can actually see I dropped it off here in Y1, right? It's about 18 times, in parentheses, it would have been 1.025 raised to the x power. That would have been my exponential function. All right, so there's number 53. Okay, thanks so much, everyone. Bye.